Every Nigerian must be instrumental to the growth and development of our nation through the use of innovative energy and idea to lead and initiate policies that will sustain the economy and enhance good governance. With all the financial turmoil facing the world, it has become pertinent for exchange of new ideas that will enhance good governance. Please subscribe to our channels, listen to our messages and engage with us. With your support, we can transform the lives of all Nigerians. Welcome to the Season 2 of the NESG Radio.
Good morning, listeners, and welcome to the NESG Radio. My name is Thelma Ezeamaka, and my guest today is Sharon Ezeamaka. Sharon Ezeamaka is a 29-year-old actress. She has been an actor since she was 5 years old. She's been studying filmmaking for the past few years, and she's very passionate about arts education. Welcome, Sharon.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm okay. I feel like it's so weird that you didn't say my guest today is my sister.
I know, right?
Sharon.
Like, I was so like... close to saying that, but I'm like, let's be official.
Mm. Really? Okay? I mean, we have the same last name. Like, okay. That left the building a long time
I'm
ago.
The interviewer. You are the interviewee.
Hi.
Okay, so everyone would like to know, when did you first appear in a movie?
Okay, so I did my first film when I was 5, but I have to say, I started my career 3 years before that.
Mm-hmm.
So I did like a commercial before I was 2. So yeah.
Okay, so do you like that you started really young, or would you have like preferred starting as an adult?
You know what? I think I like that I started really young.
Okay.
Because like, even though I started young, when I turned 18, which you know this, but when I turned 18, I took a break from acting because I had that question for myself. Like, I wanted to figure out if acting was something I was truly passionate about, or mm-hmm. if I was just doing it just because I've been doing it my whole life.
Yeah.
Turns out, it's my greatest passion.
It is.
Yeah, and like, just arts in general, you know, yeah. Filmmaking, acting, all of it. Yeah, so I'm glad I studied when I was a kid.
I know.
So I have like 25 years of experience.
That's I love awesome. That. Like, everything I'm going to ask you today, I already know the answer.
Mm-hmm.
But like, we're just trying to let every other person in.
Yeah.
You guys are welcome.
Yeah.
Okay. So who are your biggest influences apart from, I don't
you.
Know, me?
But no, genuinely, I'm not even kidding. Like, you know this. Like,
yeah.
You're like one of my biggest inspirations in life.
Yes.
Yeah. Person. But I don't have like role models, but I do have a lot of filmmakers that I've admired over time, mm-hmm. like throughout my life. Okay, let me see. Tokpe Oshin, the director in Nigeria that I'm obsessed with.
Yes.
I've loved her for so long. Meryl Streep.
Yes.
Who obviously is my goddess and I worship at her altar. Shonda Rhimes as a writer, Aaron Sorkin. Oh my god, Joaquin Silva. I've loved her since I was a child. RMD. I've worked with him since I was a kid. There's a lot of actors and artists just in general that I find inspiring me in different ways. Yeah.
Yeah, true. So what is the toughest part of the acting industry and what fact about it do you struggle with the most?
I think it's kind of hard to generalize that just because I feel like everyone has a very different experience.
Mm-hmm.
But I find that for me, and I'm going to speak to like my personal experience as an actor, the thing that I honestly struggle with the most with is auditions.
Okay.
Like, I don't do them as much anymore. I haven't done one in years, but they terrify me. Like, genuinely. Because I just finished studying like theater in school, which you know, and I had to do like auditions to get into theater school.
Ooh.
And oh my god. Auditions are terrifying. Like, I don't know. I've been doing this for such a long time, but every time I have to audition for a part, I just feel like, oh my god, I'm going to lose my mind.
No, I get that. Because for me as well, I know that it's like the getting myself to do the audition is so...
Yeah.
But once I get through it or while I'm at it, it's just like, different.
Yeah, exactly. Right? But just that feeling of, it's like, oh
just
god,
before
they're going to judge me. I don't know what's happening.
All eyes on you.
Yeah, it's kind of terrifying.
Yeesh.
Yeah.
I know the processes that actors follow generally when they have like a new role because there's so many different things you have to tap into.
Yeah.
So would like to know your process generally.
This is crazy because I've been having this conversation a lot lately, but I feel like with every part is different. But for me, my favorite thing to do is to just know the character as much as possible. Like, I want to know everything about the character because if I know the character and know all of my lines, know all the people I'm supposed to interact with, then it's easier for me to treat the character as a person, which is the whole point.
Mm-hmm.
So I just want to be as familiar as possible. I want to do as much research as possible. I want to get as comfortable as possible with the words the character has to say. Like, I just want to feel like I know this person so I can understand how to become this person. Okay. Yeah, that's kind of just my
process.
It's crazy
how you have to be that person for the time you're filming. I know. Like, I know that you would actually, even when you're not filming at that time, when you're back home or something, you're still that person. You're that character. Until the movie is over.
It's kind of easier. Like, sometimes I like to, you know, just step out of it. But it's why I like... Like, when I'm filming, I like to hang out with, like, my castmates the most. Yeah. Just because I'm just constantly in that headspace. And I don't want to get out of it too much. So anything that's going to take me out of that... Like, this is not... I'm not, like, a method actor or anything. Mm-hmm. Like, this is not that serious. But I just want to feel like I'm bringing as much, like, truth, I guess.
Yeah.
To the character.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The dedication for me.
I know. It's my life's work. What you want me to do?
So out of all the growth we've seen in the entertainment industry, not just acting. Because, I mean, I feel like the entertainment industry in Nigeria has blown.
Yeah.
Like, all over the world.
Yeah.
What's your favorite part and why?
You know what's crazy?
What?
That more people have more access to Nigerian entertainment.
Okay.
Like, it's not just like, oh, yeah, we get international recognition, blah, blah, blah. That's fine. But for me, it's more that, like, there's been so many ways that Hollywood and other industries have told Nigerian stories that have been so inaccurate and terrible that, like, I'm just really glad that, like, we can tell our own stories in our own way with our own voices, and people actually have the access to see, like, oh, this is what Nigerians are actually like. We don't sound like the made-up African accent people you have in your films. We're real people with real lives and motivations and feelings and
the
thoughts.
Internet.
And yeah, you know, we have the internet and we have cities here and things like that. I love that there's so much access that, like, if you want to see, like, want to read Nigerian books, you want to watch Nigerian films, you want to listen to Nigerian music, there's access to it. So I really love that. Mm. Yeah. That's my favorite part.
You're so smart, Jesus.
Oh my God.
Oh my God. You're so smart. I'm so proud. I'm such a proud sister right now.
Wait, I'm a proud sister. Are you kidding? You're like my princess. What?
I know, right? So what, in your opinion, has improved the most in Nollywood? So we're back to just Nollywood.
There's been a lot of different things that I've improved.
Yeah.
But, you know, this is crazy, but I'm going to sound like a broken record. But I think... So my obsession with the access that people have to our content, and I don't like to use the word content because it makes it sound a little bit, not to bash content creators, but just it makes it, like, people have access to our arts, let me put it that way.
Okay.
And I think the thing that has improved the most is as more people are having more access to our art, we're having more filmmakers and more producers, and we have a lot of women behind the scene, which I love because we need more women telling stories about Nigerian women as more than just background characters, but as people with full thoughts and feelings and emotions and all of those things. Yeah. So I think my favorite part is, like, more women behind the scenes.
Okay.
Yeah, I love that.
So now we're down to economy.
Oh my God.
How have Nollywood actors coped with the economic downturn related to COVID?
Honestly, I think COVID affected everybody.
Okay.
Like, I mean, before they were Nollywood actors, they're people first. And I feel like just the entire world has just been knocked off its axis with this 100%. Pandemic. And it's just, I think for artists, the biggest thing that has happened, one of the biggest things is, like, a lot of things in the industry have had to slow down.
Mm-hmm.
Like, less films are being made, less shows are being made, and all of those things. And I feel like it's just, I mean, I don't want to say, like, oh, this is a specific way it's affected actors, but it's just, I mean... to not be able to do your work. And I feel like that's a universal experience. Just feels like, oh, I can't wait to get back to my life and, like, not be held back by these forces that I can't control. So I feel like just as humans, just in general, like, everyone has just kind of been hit with this pandemic in the worst way. And it's nice that we're starting to go back to normal a little bit.
To an extent. But I was so shocked. I never thought anything could affect the world like this.
Dude.
Like, at the same time, it was insane.
Okay, so wait. It's like, I'm not psychic or anything, but I swear, I was in, like, Mexico, remember? I was in Mexico before the pandemic started, and I was like, this thing is going to explode. And no one believed me. Like, not like the entire world didn't believe me.
You were sending me articles every day.
I know, and here we are. I'm just saying.
And you didn't read most of your articles, I'm not going to lie.
You should read them. I don't send you articles that are not important.
They were just too long. And I was like, I don't believe this thing is going to blow up, but I should have listened.
Yeah.
I will next time, but I hope there is no...
Next time. Please, God, no.
What contributions can the private sector make for the growth of the Nollywood industry?
Oh my God, more investments. I mean, it's nice that we have bigger budgets, but, like, invest in this industry more, because it's genuinely an industry. It's not just a hobby or something people do in the background. It is making film is art, and it's also a business. So people need to invest in it that way. The more investment we have, the better arts we can produce, the more people we can create opportunities for. So please invest in this wonderful industry.
It's amazing.
Full of talented people, like, who deserve to be seen and heard, and we deserve to tell our stories with our own voices. Exactly, girl. Exactly.
Okay, so just before you go, let's let your fans in somehow. Like, okay. Is that something your fans do not know about you that you like to tell them?
I mean, I feel like, one, I'm an extremely private person. Like,
I know.
Extremely to the extreme. Like, it actually drives people crazy. Like, I'm like 2 seconds from being Howard Hughes. Like, being a recluse, I'm 2 seconds away from that. But just generally, I'm not a very, like, outgoing person. Okay. Like, people expect that because I'm an actor, I'm supposed to be, like, an extrovert and, like, loud and blah, blah, blah. But I'm not.
Yes,
I just want to create my little art and just, like, relax and have a private, like, life, you know? Yeah, that's, I think. Yeah. Okay.
So after going to art school and studying cinematography and more into acting.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm hoping, praying, wanting, wishing that you're back. Like, we obviously, a lot of people miss you on the screen and miss you generally in the industry. So, like, is that something we should expect differently? Just to see, like, a new
shine? Okay, so acting, I'm never going to give that up. I'm just taking a break from it to explore other things. But I'm really interested in exploring, like, writing and directing and producing. And that's kind of where I'm more focused on at the moment, and I'm working on a couple of projects, but when I can talk about it, because I genuinely signed an NDA,
okay.
When I can talk about it, I will. But yeah, I'm just more focused on, like, doing, because I really want to know, like, I want to know what it feels like to create something from scratch. Like, as an actor, I'm just usually hired when the script is already done and it's time to film, but I want to know, like, the behind the scenes stuff, like, what a producer does and what a director does, and I actually want to do those things. So yeah, those things. Yeah,
I love it. Thank you so much. Are there any roles, like, have you ever thought about this question? Are there any roles, like, you could never play?
I don't know that there are roles that I could never play, but I know this though, that, like, there is no amount of money that anyone will pay me to do a film or a TV show where I don't like the story or the script.
Okay.
Like, I can't do it. Because if I can't, like, if I don't genuinely like the story and genuinely like the script, I can promise you this. It's just, I won't be able to perform at my best, one, because I don't like the character. And I also will never, ever, ever promote it. Because I'm just like, I can't promote something I'm ashamed of. Like, I don't know. And because acting for me is not just like a job, it's something that I'm genuinely, it's like my life. It's everything to me, like storytelling. So I can't imagine, like, being a part of telling a story that I just don't like. Yeah. That's my hard limit.
I get that. And I get that because, like, that's so you. If you don't believe in something, it's just like, if you don't, when I say like something or someone, you cannot fake it.
I don't know how to.
Like, you don't know how to fake it.
I know.
And it's crazy for you, an actress.
I know. Exactly. It's gotten me into trouble. People are like, oh, you're not friendly. I'm like, look, I don't know how to be false about anything. If I don't truly believe in something, I'm not going to pretend that I do. If I don't like something, I don't know how to pretend that I'd like it. So it's just easier. And I feel like, honestly, we'd all just be happier people if people were more honest. Like, I'm not saying, like, go out and, like, be mean to people or be rude.
That.
Like, I'm never rude or mean or anything. But I just, I don't want to do anything that just, I don't feel like this is something that I truly feel good about doing.
Yeah,
I'm just, I don't know how to do that.
100% understand you.
Yeah.
What do you think?
You get me. Just so people that are listening know that, like, when I'm saying this and I'm not even joking, like, nobody knows me better than Thelma does. Like, genuinely, no one does. It's actually terrifying sometimes.
It's true. I actually get that because three of us, we're three sisters, right?
Yeah.
We're like best friends.
Yeah.
We are best friends. We're not like best friends.
We are. Like, we're sisters by, like, blood, but, like, we're best friends by choice.
I don't see that there's anything I could do or plan to do that I wouldn't tell my sisters. It's like,
no, it's weird.
I can't think without you.
Like, I need, like, you. We can't make decisions without each other.
Guys, I call Sharon my brain. I'm like, thank you, my brain.
Like,
thank
literally,
you for
even when we're not in the same city or the same country, we literally tell each other everything about everything we're doing. I love it.
You know all my friends. I know all your friends.
I know. So cool.
All right. Enough about us.
Okay.
Now I'm back to you. So can you give me a title of what you think your autobiography would be called?
Oh my god. Bored.
Huh?
Bored, like B-O-R-E-D.
Huh?
Because I feel like, honestly, that's... I'm not even joking.
Okay.
Like, I get bored so easily. Like, things... Like, if I don't keep myself... Like, I have to keep myself constantly, like, mentally stimulated. Or I just, like, flatline. Like, that. I don't know. Like, and I get bored. Like, I can be enjoying something this moment. And the moment I lose interest in it,
yeah,
it's like paper. It doesn't mean anything anymore. True. So, probably bored.
And it's, that's funny because it's going to be a really interesting one.
I know. I've lived an exciting life.
A really interesting one.
Yeah.
I have a story. So it was my mom's birthday last year.
Okay.
And then we were out for family lunch, right? Mm-hmm. And then at some point, because Sharon doesn't like to be out for too long. At some point, we're all having fun, taking pictures, just talking, catching up. My best friend was also, my other best friend, was also present.
Mm-hmm.
And then at some point, Sharon is reading a book.
Oh God.
On her phone.
True. Oh my God.
And I'm like... Can you be present? Like, we're all here. She's like, guys, we've eaten. Can we leave? I mean, but the dessert is coming. There's still so much to do.
But that's... No. Okay, so that's really bad manners. But I'm not even joking. I read everywhere all the time. Like, so this is when March. I've read 7 books this month so far. Like, I'm obsessed with reading.
Yeah.
Like, I don't... It's my happy place. I want to read. And I read everything, like articles, journals, books. Mm-hmm. I'm reading a medical journal about ADHD right now. Just because it's fun.
Yeah, I remember you wanted to get my friend's number because he's a doctor to ask questions.
Mm-hmm.
That's what it's about?
Yeah.
Wow.
I'm trying to find out more about it. I don't know.
I love that.
Thank you.
I wish I was this smart.
Oh my God, you're brilliant. What are you talking about?
Can you describe your life using 3 movie titles? Like, think.
3 movie titles? Like, oh my God. This is hard. Okay. I'm just going to think about, like, my favorite movies and see what happens.
Okay.
La La Land.
Okay.
Okay, just because, like, I'm obsessed with musicals and also LA is my favorite place and that's where I went to school.
I actually love La La Land.
I know. I watched that film so many times and I love the soundtrack album. I mean, I can't describe my life as Sound of Music, but I think it just came to my head because we were listening to the album yesterday.
Okay. Yes, true.
Yeah, and oh my God, it's just so crazy because I'm only talking about the films that I've talked about recently.
Mm-hmm.
Call Me by Your Name. Okay, no. Actually, Knives Out.
Okay, I don't know that one.
I know, because I've been trying to get you guys to watch it, because Christopher Plummer, the guy from Sound of Music, he's in it.
Okay.
He's, like, much older in it.
Okay.
But it's, like, I'm just using this... The only one that kind of describes my life is probably La La Land, because anyone who knows me knows I'm obsessed with musicals, and I'm obsessed with Los Angeles. So it's perfect. That's, like, totally me. Sound of Music, my obsession with musicals, like, goes deep. Like, I love films... But, like, if I have to choose between a film and a musical, honestly, I think I might pick a musical.
You definitely will.
Oh, my God. I love them. Knives Out, because I can be vicious when I want to be.
Mm-hmm.
But, like, I will do it in a way that, like, you probably will not be able to recover from it.
Mm-hmm.
But, like, I'm genuinely, like, naturally a nice person. But if you try me, like, don't.
Oh, you try your loved ones.
Yeah. Like, that's even the worst. Like, if you try people, like, care about, like, I'm, like, in destroy mode.
Yeah.
That's, I only know one setting.
Yeah. I probably would have said I would have described you like Xena, the warrior princess. Anyway.
Oh my God, no, wait, hold on.
Yes. That one. It was so much fun talking to you, sister. I'm so glad we could do this.
Me too.
And thank you everyone for listening. Remember, you can catch more episodes on www.nesgroup.org/podcast. Until next time, have a great one. Bye.
Thank you.